I love how the show is never predictable. You don't know what they're going to do next.
That's 100% true.
So how shocking are the scripts?
They're always shocking. We're to a point now, after the first season with the Holy Mother Forking Shirtballs reveal, that since then, after a table read, it's not uncommon for Ted or Kristen at the end of a table read to say, "Is this real?" Like, and Michael go, "Yeah, like that's real." You know, I can remember last season in season three when they go through the mail chute and land in the postal office of The Good Place, and Eleanor realizes she can't swear, and she says, "We're in The Good Place." When we finished that table read, Ted immediately turned to Mike and said, "Is that real?" Mike said, "Yeah, we're in The Good Place." And like, the entire room got chills. I'm getting them now. Like, we were in the actual Good Place for the very first time. Mm-hmm. And all of this is pretend, you know? But it's so remarkable that we've grown in these seasons to care so much about these completely made-up people. Like, we really do care about the fate of Tahani and Eleanor and Jason and Chidi. And of course now Janet and Michael somehow. We've come to find very human qualities in these eternal beings.
Yeah.
What's it like going into your last season knowing it's your last season at the very beginning?
I'm thrilled. Obviously we're nearing the end of shooting. I'm not in every episode. I have the gist of what's happening. Mike sits us down one by one and walks us through what's happening. I'm thrilled for the audience to see it because this is, as you say, a show that has taken so many risks and uprooted itself and undone established reality without the ticking clock of a series finale. They've done this within, you know, they've made series-ending decisions three episodes into a season kind of thing. Like they, you know, Eleanor's confession, that would have been, in the olden days, that would have been a cliffhanger at the end of a season, if not a series. And what these writers, the smartest, funniest writers in Hollywood, are willing to do and going to do with a finite end is really exciting.
I'm sorry, last question.
What are you going to miss the most about playing Shawn?
I mean, honestly, on a personal level, just going to work with these people every day. I'm not entirely convinced I'm not hooked up to tubes in a hospital bed somewhere enjoying the most lovely of comas because I get to go and play with Ted Danson and Kristen Bell and William Jackson Harper and Jamila Jamil and Darcy Carden and Manny Jacinto. I mean, that's crazy. And then the people that we're able to play with is, you know, Tia Sirkar and Jamie Williamson and Bumba John Bumba and, you know, all the demons. It's... there's no way this is real, right? I'm asleep, right? And I don't know. That's on a personal level. Story-wise, I'm so excited for the culmination of this journey into ethics. This is a half-hour sitcom on network television. Like, this show shouldn't exist.